This episode is all about honeybee development. Honeybees are insects, and insects can go through either complete metamorphosis or incomplete metamorphosis. I'm only going to focus on the one of those two pathways that honeybees take, and that's complete metamorphosis. So what does that mean? Well, metamorphosis means changing body, metamorphosis, over time. So honeybees go through this very distinct body characteristic change series over time. We call that complete metamorphosis if they go through four stages. Those four stages being the egg, the larva, the pupa, and the adult. So that's complete metamorphosis. So let's think then specifically about the three immature stages of honeybee development. Those would be the egg, the larvae, and the pupae. Beekeepers collectively call these three stages the brood stages of bees. So when you hear beekeepers say honeybee brood or bee brood, they are referring collectively to eggs, larvae, and pupae. So let's start at the egg stage. A queen will lay an egg in the back of a cell. And that egg typically lasts about 3 days. Now, eggs are really, really small. They're really the bane of new beekeepers' frustrations and experiences. Beekeepers always want to see eggs. They always want to see that their queen is present, but they're so tiny in there in the back of a cylindrical cell, it's very difficult to see. I always say that eggs are roughly the shape of a piece of rice, just much, much, much smaller. So let's think about this cell architecture. You've got this cylinder. A queen sticks her abdomen into that cylinder all the way to the back and deposits this egg. So this egg is about 1.5 millimeters long, and it's standing upright in the cell. Now, as that egg ages, it starts to tilt until it's lying completely on its side in the cell, at which time a larva emerges from that egg. And again, the average egg developmental time is somewhere in the neighborhood of about 3 days. That's true for workers, queens, and drones. A larva emerges, it hatches from this egg around 3 days after that egg was laid. What is a larva? A larva is a little worm-like creature that's essentially the feeding and development growth period of that bee. So you've got this little tiny worm in the very back of the cell that emerged from this egg. If you were to zoom into that larva, you would see that it has multiple body sections. You could see that because there's multiple rings around the body. It almost looks like stacking successive marshmallows that get smaller and smaller and smaller until you get to that little smallest marshmallow at the tip. So it's this ringed body. And if you're a good trained entomologist, you'll know what each of those sections become on the adult bee. But for purposes of this discussion, I'll just keep it very simple. You've got this little worm lying in the back of the cell, ready to receive food. And so the youngest of larvae are really tiny. They're very small, the size of an egg, right? Soon as she emerges from her egg, she's really not bigger at all than that egg from which she emerges. So that larva will begin to be fed by worker bees, and that larva will develop in that cell. And at some point, they become just big enough for most beekeepers to be able to see them. Worker bees are the bees that provide the food to the developing larvae. They have special glands in their heads that they use to produce that food. We call it brood food or royal jelly, depending on the larval target. That worker bee will visit that cell, she'll go into that cell, and she'll spit up some of that food for the larvae. That developing larvae is sitting in the back of that cell. She'll receive that food, and then she eats herself in circles, spinning around to eat that food in front of her. Now, the youngest of larvae are usually sitting in large volumes of this food. In fact, when beekeepers pick up their frames and look into the cells, those youngest larvae are often referred to as milk brood because it looks like they are sitting in a pile of milk in the back of those cells. And that milk, of course, being the brood food or the royal jelly, depending on the larvae. As that larva eats that food, it grows to fill that cell. So much so that that's all you'll see in the oldest larvae. These larvae just completely swollen in that cell. Now, beekeepers use a term when referring to larvae because larvae are sitting in that cell in the shape of the letter C. So they're in that cell developing, spinning around in that cell slowly as they're eating food. So they might refer to those as C-shaped larvae. So milk brood typically refers to the very youngest of brood. Those C-shaped larvae can be applied to any of those stages of larval development. And the reason I point this out is because when larvae are not in that shape in their cell, when they're twisted or contorted in different directions in that cell, that's often an indication of a problem in that cell. Now, those larvae are also shiny and pearly white. Those two features are very important because that shininess, that pearly whiteness, those are distinguishing characteristics of healthy larvae. If you see larvae that aren't in the shape of the C, if you see discolored larvae or dull larvae, then you might have a problem, a brood disease or something of the sort. Once those larvae have finished feeding, the bees will cap over that cell and the larvae will unravel itself and orient to where the head is towards the capping of that cell. This stage is still a larval stage, but we refer to it as the prepupae larval stage. That's the stage of larval development immediately before the pupae. At this point, if you were to uncap that cell, it looks like a larvae that's just pointing its head at you. From there, that larva develops into a pupa, which starts to look like the adult bee. You can see the head, you can see the thorax and the abdomen, you can see the legs developing and the wing buds. And that pupae initially is white, but it progresses through different colors as it ages to become an adult bee. One of the first things that will become colored on a pupae will be the two large eyes. Initially, they will become purple, so beekeepers often refer to these as purple-eyed pupae. And then those pupae will continue to develop to where they darken and look like an adult bee. So all of that occurs under a capped cell. You can't see it unless you remove the cell capping. From there, once the pupal bee has finished fully developing, it will transition into the adult bee stage, and the adult bee stage will emerge from its cell by chewing a hole in that capping, opening the capping, and coming out. So adult bees can be distinguished because they've got fully developed wings, they've got hair on the body. Those are the two key important distinguishing characteristics between an adult bee and a pupal bee. Now, I've given a very general overview, but there's actually some complex topics from an entomology perspective to think about in this developmental stage. So let's take a little bit of further dive into this. So that was a very general overview of honeybee development, but I want to share some things with you that are a little bit technical, but I find very fascinating about bees. Let's start again from the egg stage. So the queen lays this egg, and inside of that egg is a developing embryo that ultimately becomes a larva that hatches or emerges from that egg. Well, that larva is what we call a first instar larvae. It's the first developmental stage of that larvae. What does instar mean? In entomology, instar means period between molts. Now you've got to ask, what does a molt mean? Well, a molt is when an insect sheds its exoskeleton, its skin. Think about it from snakes. We all know that snakes shed their skin. That's necessary because snakes have to shed their skin so that they can grow. Well, insects are similar. They have to shed their exoskeleton in order to grow. The shedding of that exoskeleton is called a molt. Honeybees actually molt. Most beekeepers don't know about this or don't even think about it. So as that larva emerges from its egg, it's a first instar larva. After it goes through its first molt, it becomes a second instar larva. After it goes through its second molt, it becomes a third instar larva, and so forth. The first four larval instars, 1, 2, 3, and 4, are the larval instars during which the larva eats. That's when it's consuming food. Its fourth molt ushers in its fifth larval instar, and that fifth instar is the prepupal stage that I referred to earlier. This happens under a capped cell. The egg and larval instars 1 through 4 all happen in open cells. Then the bees cap that cell and the larva sheds its skin. It molts that fourth time and becomes the fifth instar or the prepupa. At that point, it looks like a larva. It is a larva. It's just pointing at you in the cell if you were to uncap it. Once that instar, once that fifth instar, that prepupa molts, that would be the fifth molt, it becomes the sixth instar, which is the pupa of the bee. Let's think closely about this pupa. This is a very interesting topic to me because a lot of people think that that pupa grows legs and that pupa grows wings and that pupa grows hair. That's not really what's happening. What you see when you see a pupa in a cell is you've got the skin of a pupa, but on the inside of that is a essentially bee whose tissues are reorganizing to become an adult bee. So that pupa has to shed its skin, that would be the sixth molt, to become that adult bee. That sixth and final molt we refer to as eclosion. So that's when it becomes an adult. So that pupa sheds its skin, it ecloses, it becomes an adult. And that new adult bee actually remains in the cell up to a day and a half to 2 days before it emerges. Technically, when that adult bee emerges from its cell, it's not emerging as a brand new adult bee. It's been an adult bee maybe for a day and a half or 2 days. Really what's happening is you've got this adult bee stage happening in a cap cell. It then emerges from its cell as the adult bees that we know and love. You essentially have all of these things happening before you ever see an adult bee emerge from the cell. It's really fantastic if you think about it. Now, remember, we've got three types of bees in the hive. We've got workers, drones, and queens, and all of them undergo this complete metamorphosis to produce the adult bees that we see meandering about the nest. I'm going to give some very big generalizations here about the typical age or the typical length in days that each of these stages lasts for the bee. Queens, as an example. Their egg stage is usually about 3 days. Their uncapped larvae for about 4.5 days. They're capped for about another half day, and then they become prepupae in those cells for about 2 days. They're pupae for about 4.5 days. They shed their pupal skin and become an adult in their cell for about a half day before they emerge. If you add up all of these, it's 16 days. From egg to adult, it's about 16 days. Workers, we'll look at it. Its egg range is about 3 days. Its uncapped larval stage is about 5.5 days. It's another half day. As a capped larvae, about 2.5 days as a prepupae, 8 days as a pupa, a half day about as an adult before it emerges at a total of 21 days later from egg to adult. Drones, as we all know, are a little bit longer. Their egg stage is about 3 days. Their uncapped larval stage is about 6.5 days. Their capped larvae for 2 days, prepupae for 3 days, pupae for 9 days. They spend about half a day in their cell before they emerge as an adult. This entire timeline takes about 24 days. And of course, depending on food, temperature, and a whole host of other environmental cues, these developmental day lengths can vary, but in general, queens take about 16 days, workers 21 days, drones 24 days, and it's really a modern marvel how this happens in our colonies all of the time, just so the bees have enough adults emerging to do the task necessary to move that colony forward. As beekeepers, it really benefits us to know about these stages of bee development. First of all, just to know the biology that's going on in our hives, but also to be able to spot problems as they occur throughout the egg stage, the larval stage, the pupal stage, or the adult stage. Also, thinking a little bit about this really makes you appreciate how fantastic honeybees are. All of this happens right up under our noses in our colonies every day to produce those adult bees we get to interact with and have the fortune of tending.